I'm not making a run for the White House, but I do have a plan to cover at least half of the 45 million Americans who need health insurance. Hi, I'm Nick Gillespie. The candidates won't talk about my plan because they're too scared to talk straight about one of the most emotional issues on the campaign trail. To help the kids
growing taller every day. In this video, a family copes with the sudden illness of a little girl. Then Amy got a bruise that wouldn't go away. And is forced to sell the family home to pay the medical bills. I am the captain of a health insurance company. Sometimes the mood is lighthearted, like depicting insurance company execs as plundering pirates. But the underlying message is always heavy. Yo ho, go ahead and die. Old people and families are being abused by our healthcare system. The candidates have made reform a top priority.
Bold solutions for America's healthcare mess.
I will sign a universal health care plan into law.
While the candidates duel over who's got the best plan, they ignore the easiest solution, my solution. Call it the Gillespie plan. If you want health insurance, get some.
I was going to get health insurance, and then I got drunk. So.
His buddy doesn't have insurance either. His employer offered it.
But they're taking too much out of my paycheck for it, so if they take the money out of my paycheck for health insurance, I won't have enough to make rent.
We found these guys on LA's famous Sunset Strip. Well, more like a back alley near the strip. Don't expect to see them featured in a campaign ad.
My hands are f***ed up. See how my knuckles like sticks out about half an inch above the rest of my hand?
They don't quite pull at the heartstrings like a sick little girl. But don't young musicians deserve insurance too?
Yeah. It'd be nice to have health insurance once in a while.
He says he has to choose between housing and health.
So I'll just be living on the street, so it's like, what do you want? Do you want a house or do you want to be healthy?
This guy says he's in the same boat because coverage is simply out of reach.
That's one luxury I can't afford then, because I have to eat and have rent, and you know what I mean?
Isn't there some way they could get covered? It probably costs them around $100 per month to buy insurance. Way too much for someone on the verge of homelessness. Then again, how much does this guy spend on partying?
At least $100 a month.
Yeah.
Doing what?
Yeah.
Whatever I can get my hands on.
Where does his money go?
I work out, so supplements and stuff cost me like $300 a month. Vitamins, protein pack, you know what I mean?
It's very clear that guy would be able to afford health insurance if he really wanted to.
Dr. Glenn Whitman is an economist at Cal State Northridge.
He might not get as much protein powder, but he might get more of what he really needs, the medicines and treatments that he needs to help him live longer.
Ah, but who wants to give up properly pumped pecs or a cool wardrobe? This guy doesn't have insurance either.
I do spend a lot of money on like clothes, stuff like that. I'm a black man. We spend a lot of money on clothes.
If he spent less on clothes, could he buy insurance?
That's not gonna happen. I'm gonna go to the free clinics and look good. That's what I'm gonna do. I might be sick inside, but I'm gonna look good on the outside.
How come politicians never talk about guys like him?
The reason people don't have health insurance isn't because they don't want it. It's because they can't afford it.
Affordable health care for all.
So health care must be made affordable.
Affordable is a very difficult thing to define. There are those who really can't afford health insurance, and there are those who can afford it and simply choose not to buy it because they want to buy something else.
People who could buy coverage but don't? We're used to hearing about the most sympathetic stories. Children, families, single moms.
Everywhere I go, single moms trying to figure out how are they going to get health care for their families.
But come on, folks on the Sunset Strip aren't the same as regular Americans. Well, actually, they're more representative than you might think. Although too many families and children are suffering, most uninsured people don't have kids. They're generally young, relatively healthy adults with fewer grown-up responsibilities. So folks like these shouldn't be our only image of the uninsured, because they're more likely to look like these guys. And like our Sunset Strip crew, a surprising number of the uninsured could get coverage if they wanted.
So people currently classified as uninsured, a conservative estimate says about 45% of them would be able to get health insurance right now if they wanted it.
That estimate comes from a study headed by a scholar from Johns Hopkins University, which says that those who could get covered if they wanted to fall into one of two categories.
People who either could afford to buy health insurance with their current income or already qualify for some form of government assistance in the form of Medicaid or SCHIP, programs like that.
SCHIP covers kids and Medicaid covers the poor. Another program, Medicare, covers folks over 65. So although the system needs reform, it's not exactly giving seniors a boot in the butt. Go ahead and die. 11 million Americans qualify for existing government programs, but they just don't sign up for them. Why not?
It might mean they are embarrassed to take advantage of it, or that they don't know that the program is available to them.
Of course, most campaign speeches focus on cost.
So my commitment is to make sure that we bring the costs of health insurance down.
Costs do seem to be shooting up higher all the time, and there are plenty of sensible things politicians could do about that. But remember, nearly half the uninsured could be covered, and the real figure is almost certainly higher.
There's a lot of people out there that choose to buy a lot of things that they can't afford.
The Johns Hopkins study looked at how much money people make. Families earning less than $58,000 per year were considered too poor to afford health insurance. What the study didn't look at is all the other things they spend money on. More than $1,000 each year on telephone services, according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics. Alcohol, more than $400. Cigarettes, personal care products, clothes, eating out.
Well, going to eat, we know my man over here spend a lot. You know, I spend a little less. And Nick spend half is what we spend. You know?
If millions could get insurance without any more help from Washington, why don't the candidates urge them to get covered? Pronto.
Politicians aren't in the business of telling us what we need to hear. They're in the business of telling us what we want to hear. You're not going to get as many votes telling people you need to change your life, you need to fix your problems on your own, as you're going to get saying to people, we're going to solve all of your problems for you.
The issue is that not every problem has a political solution. Could a President McCain get these guys to care less about partying? Could a President Obama get this guy to spend less on protein powder? Could either get him to care less about clothes? Or get him to care at all? He says he makes enough money to buy insurance, but...
Nothing's gonna happen to me, bro. I mean, I'm the luckiest guy in America.
So how about some real straight talk for a change?
If we separate those who truly can't get coverage from those who can, we can focus more on helping the needy. So if you can get coverage, don't wait for Washington. Go out and get some. Go on. For Reason TV, I'm Nick Gillespie.